young people so often get such a sort of bad press. And I just think on this day, you know, as much as any other day, just to say, well done, you know, congratulations. It's just fantastic what you, you know, what you've achieved. And what we want to do here in Downing Street and in government is to hear from you, because you've achieved extraordinary things, amazing things over the last year. You were telling me about it earlier. And we just want to hear from you what you think we can do to kind of, you know, make more success for you and for other young people. Not just you know, when you're at school, but also about when you then want to go from school into work. Ask me any question you like, you know, I'll try and answer all of them. But also I just want to hear from your own personal experience, because I've just heard about the great things you've done. So who wants to start? Shafiq.
I'd just like to ask you, Deputy Prime Minister, if such a small programme, because we get our funding from corporate businesses, such a small programme made such a big impact, and we're all over London here, why isn't there a programme like this made by the government, or even a much larger scale? Because we can't really, Arrival Education can't work with everyone, and we can't really touch everyone.
What we need to do, and of course we'll, you know, I'll make sure that happens, is that we now sit down with people like Daniel and say, look, this seems to be great. Let's just look at this carefully and, you know, really analyse what went right, and then try and make sure that it's picked up in other parts of the country. Just tell me a little bit about the relationship you have with what do you call the people who coaches?
It's great, because it's like she's busy. She has a job and stuff, and she takes time every month to come and meet with me.
How much
and
time?
Help. Like, we meet once a month for a couple hours, like in the evening after work and stuff.
Where, at your home or?
No, we meet at like a restaurant or something.
So it's a couple of hours every month?
Yeah.
That's basically been it, has it? A couple of hours every month? Just,
yeah.
That's amazing. So a couple of hours every month, just talking through what you're, can you tell me a little bit about, how can a couple of hours make such a huge difference to your grades? That's just incredible.
Talking to someone that's a banker in a like really good place allows me to see the kind of steps I would need to take for my own decisions, instead of like taking some sort of degree or going in the steps of taking different subjects to become something that I don't want to be.
Out of interest, how do your mum and dad feel about it?
I mean, yeah, they feel it's completely fine, because I've told them about the programme, and they came to the induction day when the whole thing started, and they were really happy and everything, because they thought that is quite different, because of all the stuff I've been doing. I've been to quite a lot of places, like I've been to Cornwall and places like that to do different projects. And yeah, they think it's really beneficial for me. So they're really proud.
How do you get other people to start, you know, dreaming these big dreams and believing that they, you know, they can do better? I mean, do you think they have to kind of go through the whole thing themselves, or can you communicate that?
Well, not really. As we all said, we're all leaders in our own community, so we're really influential in our own communities. And if you really change the people, like myself or Jordana or Noor Jahan, then it creates a ripple effect.
I mean, I think one of the things we politicians have got to do is kind of celebrate and support what you do, not constantly say that, you know, young people are a threat or, you know, you know, a problem in our communities. But do you feel that in your communities? Do you feel that you are talked about and described by people in the community in a way that's not always positive?
And I think that with just two stereotypes, and that at the end of the day, I know people that maybe are on the wrong path, but they're still the most smart people I've ever met in my life. Maybe not academically, but they are, and they could start their business and be a millionaire. And it's just the support needed in order for them to grow.
I've really found this, you know, genuinely kind of inspiring, and I can, you know, promise you one thing that I'm going to do is immediately go away and try and, you know, we'll work together to see how we can, yeah, how we can spread your success. But I think what you've done is truly, truly remarkable, and you must be immensely proud of what you've done, and I guess your families and your communities will be very proud of you as well. So look, just keep going, I think. but thanks very much for telling me all about that, and hopefully more and more people will benefit in the way you guys have benefited. And I'll keep this on. All right, take care then.
Thank you.